Some people with severe persistent mental illnesses like schizophrenia and bipolar disorder have been seeing dramatic results on a keto diet. So research is still really new in this field, but one study of patients who were hospitalized with severe disorders like schizophrenia, bipolar, and depression were treated with a medical keto diet. And 28 out of 31 of them stuck with this approach. And of those 28, 100% of them saw improvements in their symptoms. And even more wild is 43% of them achieved remission. So this is pretty incredible results for such severe conditions. So today we're going to talk about why metabolic treatments work for mental health conditions, what they are, and how they might be the future of mental health treatment. Okay, first, let's start with some stories, and then we're going to move into the science of why metabolic treatments like keto seem to be so effective at treating mental health conditions. So first, let me tell you about my friend Kirsten. She's a therapist. She's been struggling for over a year with debilitating migraines, and she tried a ton of treatments, from medications to chiropractors to doctors, physical therapists. And when she started seeing a migraine specialist, he encouraged her to try a medical keto diet. Now, you might wonder, like, why keto? So the keto diet has a really well-established history as an effective treatment for epilepsy, especially in children who don't respond well to medication. So the reduction in seizures has been linked to the production of ketones, which help stabilize neuronal activity. This effect on stabilizing brain function is super interesting to mental health researchers who are beginning to see big improvements for people with other brain disorders. So what's keto? And how does it do it? The medical ketogenic diet is a high-fat, low-carbohydrate, and moderate-protein diet specifically designed to force the body into a state of ketosis. You're not limiting calories or starving yourself. You're switching the fuel that you're burning from carbohydrates to mostly fat. Ketosis is a metabolic state in which the body produces ketone bodies as an alternative fuel source. The diet is carefully formulated, and it's generally 80 to 90% fat. And yes, that's a lot, with the rest being protein and carbohydrates. Okay, so back to Kirsten. She got on keto, and within a few weeks, her migraines had almost completely gone away. Okay, so what about mental health? Not just migraines. You've got to hear about Lauren's experience. You may know her from the channel Living Well with Schizophrenia.
My name is Lauren Kennedy West, and over the last 6 years, I've been publicly sharing my experience of living with schizoaffective disorder on YouTube on my channel, Living Well with Schizophrenia. In December of 2023, I decided to give using metabolic therapy, specifically ketogenic therapy, or what I've referred to as medical keto, a try in terms of seeing if it could help manage or even treat my mental illness, schizoaffective disorder. Before this, I had primarily been using treatments like medication and therapy to manage my illness, but I still had breakthrough symptoms that included things like hallucinations or delusions or paranoia, and especially the negative symptoms that were really never touched by medication. My care team didn't know a lot or really anything about medical keto, and so it was crucial for me to get a professional on board who could kind of advise us on how to effectively do it. This was in the form of a keto coach who was a therapist specifically trained in nutrition, especially around medical ketogenic therapy. I wasn't really sure what was going to come of trying out this intervention, and honestly, just changing the food I consume felt like a stretch in terms of being able to improve my mental health. However, I have been completely blown away throughout this process at how drastically it has improved and changed my experience of my illness. I no longer experience symptoms, positive symptoms, negative symptoms, cognitive symptoms. They've all been vastly improved. And my experience of my illness and subsequently my experience of my life has completely changed. And over the course of the last 10 or 11 months, I've gradually reduced my medication further and further to a point where I am now completely off of my psychiatric medication and more stable than ever. I've been documenting this process extensively on our YouTube channel over the last 10 or 11 months, and you can check that out there. Our YouTube channel is actually now named Living Well After Schizophrenia.
So Lauren's story is pretty mind-blowing. She had schizophrenia, a disease that most people have previously thought to be a disorder that you just manage or you just cope with. But with metabolic treatments, people are starting to see remission with it. So how does this work? Dr. Chris Palmer, a Harvard psychiatrist, has been passionately researching the connection between metabolic disorders and mental health disorders. He's the author of the book Brain Energy, which lays out the case for mental health conditions being caused by metabolic disorders. And he's seen some pretty dramatic results using metabolic treatments like keto, intermittent fasting, sleep, and exercise to treat them.
So the underlying theory really is that the brain disorders that we call mental illness are largely metabolic disorders impacting the brain. And although metabolism gets really complicated fast, the reality is that there are some treatments that are actually quite simple. Diet, exercise, sleep, lifestyle factors that can actually play really a foundational role in treating mental illness. And I think the shocking thing, so most people hear that and they think, well, yeah, of course, good diet is good for your health and maybe mental health. The shocking thing is that when you actually understand the science, you can use specific dietary interventions, for example, like the ketogenic diet, to treat really serious, severe, chronic brain conditions like schizophrenia, bipolar disorder, and other mental health conditions. And to me, the thing that's so hopeful about stories like that is that it's not that medical keto is going to cure everyone, but it opens up entirely new ways to understand these illnesses and completely different strategies other than just try another pill. It opens up completely new strategies that we should be considering.
So what does the research say? Do we know why it works for some people and not for others? Research indicates that the keto diet might positively impact certain mental health conditions due to its effects on metabolism, neurotransmitter function, and inflammation. Ketones have been shown to improve mitochondrial function, reduce oxidative stress, and protect neurons, which is really beneficial for cognitive function. And it also might help with conditions like Alzheimer's disease and mild cognitive impairment due to aging.
Metabolism is actually fundamental to the definition of living organisms. So yeah. It is massive, super complicated. The simple version is food into energy and building blocks. And that's what powers our brains. That's what makes us function. That's what makes us healthy and or not healthy. Yeah. And when there are problems with metabolism, fundamentally, there will be problems with the way cells function. And when cells in your brain are not functioning properly, you can have symptoms of mental illness.
There's also some evidence that the keto diet might be helpful for alcoholism, PTSD, and even eating disorders.
And what I'm here to say is there's hope. There is hope for those people, for you. If people understand the metabolic theory, the metabolic basis of brain disorders, we can help people heal and recover. It helps us understand current treatments a little better, but it also opens up entirely new possibilities in terms of new medications we might think about, weight loss drugs, maybe for your brain health as well. But also dietary interventions like the ketogenic diet or other diets, exercise, sleep, and other things.
Right now, we don't have enough research to tell us exactly why the ketogenic diet may be so helpful. We know that it changes the metabolism for the better, but it also might help reduce inflammation, increase the levels of GABA, which is a calming neurotransmitter, and stabilize blood sugar levels. This prevents the fluctuations that are linked to irritability, anxiety, and depressive symptoms. In an interview with NPR, a psychiatrist said, once you trend towards more normal mitochondrial function and metabolic health, that's restoring neurotransmitter systems. It's even restoring blood flow to the brain. So keto can be really effective for some people with some conditions, including massive benefits for some really severe conditions. But the next question is it practical or sustainable?
First, I want to just point out that if you're using a ketogenic diet for a mental health condition, it's not at all clear that you need to do it for life. Usually when people use it to treat their epilepsy, they only need to do it for somewhere between 2 and 5 years. And then you can stop the diet and your seizures stay away. And what we're hoping in the mental health field is that the same brain benefits will apply so that people can do a ketogenic intervention for a couple of years and then maybe be able to transition to a different type of a diet, maybe more of a paleo diet or Mediterranean diet or something else, where they can still maintain the health benefits and still stay well and remitted and recovered, but not necessarily have to do the diet. But even for people who end up do having to do the diet, there are people with epilepsy who've been on this diet for more than 40 years. And the reason it's so sustainable for them, because this is perplexing to a lot of people, because a lot of people have trouble losing even 5 or 10 pounds and keeping it off.
Most people do.
And so it's like, how do these patients with severe mental or neurological health conditions, how do they do it for so long? These people are fighting for their lives. They're fighting for their brain health. It is so much easier to do a ketogenic diet than to have severe, crippling, suicidal depression. It's not even a close contest. It is so much easier just to do a diet. Yeah. The friend that you just described who had migraine headaches that were treatment resistant, it's probably a lot easier to do a keto diet than to have migraine headaches and be in bed incapacitated.
Yep. I said, is it hard to stick with? She's been doing it for 6 months now. And I haven't stuck with a diet for 6 months. I was like, well, is this hard? Like, do you miss? And she's like, no, it's not. I choose between eating keto or being in bed with a migraine. It's like an easy choice.
Exactly. And so I think for people who don't need a ketogenic diet, I'm not at all suggesting that everybody goes on a ketogenic diet.
Right.
This is a treatment for pretty serious health conditions. But yeah, for the people who get remission, it really feels nothing short of a miracle to a lot of people.
We have to admit that changing to a keto diet can be really challenging. You have to restrict certain foods, and this can take a lot of time and money and energy, and it can restrict social interactions, and this can add stress to life. Plus, it can be hard to get adequate nutrients without eating a lot of carbohydrates. I also wonder about the impact on the gut microbiome when there's so little fiber in the diet. It's still too early to know what works and why, but this is a promising approach. There are still a lot of questions to be answered, and for each person, it's important to weigh the risks and the benefits of each treatment option. If you're considering this, you should work with a doctor or a nutritionist or a psychiatrist who understands metabolic treatments to decide what is the best treatment for you. Dr. Palmer recommends that you find a clinician who can help you navigate the process. I'll just link some resources below that may be helpful, because I think it's just great to have another tool in our tool belt. Okay, hope you found this video helpful. Thank you for watching and take care. Hey, if you found any part of this video helpful, I'd really appreciate it if you could give it a thumbs up or comment below what you found was helpful. Also, if you can think of someone who might benefit from this video, if you could share it, that'll help them. But all of these things help tell the algorithm that this content is helpful for people, and then they'll show it to more people who it can help. So really appreciate it. Thank you so much for being here. Take care.